And today we are talking about encouraging our team members to challenge the process and take the initiative to get things done. So I've been working on this a lot. I do have a few things that I do. So right now we have a monthly meeting. And in the monthly meeting, I'll always bring up topics or talk about future changes to get people's input on how we should deal with those changes. And then I kind of open it up to the team and say, does anyone have any comments or suggestions? And there have been a lot of people lately that are just coming to the meeting with all these full-blown ideas and challenging processes. And part of me is like, hey, come to me like when you think of this. Don't hold all this in to our until our monthly meeting. But what I'm finding is that some people are just more comfortable in a group setting whenever they share their ideas. So I'm okay with that, but there are some team members that I do have their complete trust and they just come to me immediately. But man, I really want to be able to develop that trust with everyone. But anyway, so we have these monthly meetings and people will bring up things that challenge the process. This is where as a leader, I'm really working on listen to understand instead of listening to reply, because a lot of times I kind of know what my reply is as they're talking about what they would like to have changed. But I really need to just keep asking follow-up questions to really get a better understanding of what exactly they're saying. So that's one way that my team members challenge the process. Another thing that I've done is I've challenged my team to be cross-functional. I made a cross-functional matrix where I have each of my team members listed and then all of the inventory job types, everything that we do as a team. And I'm finding that people are experts in their area, but they're not really cross-functional or certified in another area. So I've challenged everyone to be cross-functional and certified in everyone else's area. That way we can be a more complete team. And what I'm finding with that is whenever someone's learning a different job type, they're questioning some of the processes that go along with it because they know a more efficient way. And I think a lot of the times the processes have just been in place for so long. So as someone that's a supervisor and I know how limited our time is, I definitely want to make things as efficient as possible and reduce as much waste as I can. So I really encourage that behavior to call things out. And we will try it. If someone knows a better way to do something and it doesn't mess with the quality of our work, then I'm definitely open to trying it. And then maybe that will become the new standard operating procedure for that job type. So those are the two things I'm currently doing. I'm really excited for this. Really excited for this discussion post week because now I can watch everyone else's and maybe get some more ideas that I can implement with my team when it comes to having them challenge the process and take initiative. Thanks, everyone.